Hello people, in this video we want to look at the lab diagnosis of Entamoeba histolytica. Okay, just as a one line, if you have to say, you can demonstrate the trophozoites and cysts in the stools. Okay, in the stool you can demonstrate the trophozoite and cysts. These are the trophozoite, precyst, cyst, uninucleate, binucleate, quadrinucleate, mature quadrinucleate cyst, which is the infective form. So you can demonstrate these in the stools. Now if there is trophozoite, then it is an active infection. If there is a quadrinucleate cyst only, then it can be a carrier. Okay, so basically you will have to demonstrate the cyst or the trophozoite in the stool. Also you can do some serological tests like antibody detection, etc. And in case of hepatic amebiosis, that is the liver, etc., you can do some imaging techniques. This is just a very high level diagnosis. Now let us get into the details. Now if it is intestinal amebiasis, how will you do the diagnosis? Okay, if it is intestinal amebiasis, you can do stool examination. You can culture the stool on these media. You can take some mucosal scrapings, wet mount, etc. Sero diagnosis, again you have ELISA, latex agglutination test, etc. And molecular diagnosis, you have DNA probe, etc. So let's look at the details. Okay, in stool examination for intestinal amebiasis, guys, we are talking only about the intestine here. Wake up. So here we are talking only about the intestine. Okay, right. So here you will do stool examination. What you will you see in the stool? Stool basically macroscopic appearance, you will see something. Microscopy and also you will see something. What will you see in macroscopic appearance? You can collect the stool into a basically a container and you can see that it will not stick, correct? So it will not stick. The stool is foul smelling, that you already know. You have seen all this in the differences between bacillary and amoebic dysentery. So the stool will be foul smelling, semi-liquid, and there will be lot of stool, and there will be brownish black in color. It is intermingled with blood and mucose. It does not adhere to the container. This much you have already seen. If you remember our last video, right guys, let's go back and see that. In amoebic dysentery, remember how the stools will be? The stools will be a lot. There will be feces mainly with little blood and mucus, right? They will be streaked with blood and mucus. There will be foul smelling. There will be copious amounts of feces. The frequency will be less, but there will be a lot of stools, right? So this is what you will remember. This is the macroscopic picture. And remember, it will not stick to the container, right? So all this much if you know. It will not stick to the container. And you also know what will happen in the microscopy. Microscopy also you have studied, correct? So in microscopy, what will you see? There is less cellular exudate, correct? And it contains of epithelial cells, macrophages, few macrophages will be there. Lot of eosinophils can be there. Then Charcot-laden crystals can be there. The RBCs are yellow and brownish. They are in clumps, right? What else, guys? See, Charcot-laden crystals, they are diamond-shaped, clear, refractile crystals they are. What are these Charcot-laden crystals? These are diamond shaped, you can see already here. You have seen the Charcot-laden crystals. You remember this? These things you are seeing here? These are Charcot-laden crystals. Okay. I think you understood, right, where the Charcot-laden crystals are. Guess here, these are the Charcot-laden crystals. They are diamond shaped, clear, refractile crystals. Okay. So these are diamond shaped, clear, refractile crystals. Where will you see these refractile Charcot-laden crystals? In intestinal amebiasis, remember. Okay. Then moving on to microscopic appearance, you will be able to see trophozoites. Right, you can see motile trophozoites which have engulfed RBC, all that you can see. Then in fresh stool only you can see, okay, all this trophozoites and all. The nucleus is not very visible, faint outline only you can detect. Okay. Trophozoites, which are motile, engulfed RBC. Okay, you can see. So what about the cyst? Can you see the cysts? Yes, you can see the cysts also. See, somehow we have not mentioned that in the diagram. Cysts also you can see. These cysts, how they will look? Smooth, thin-walled, refractile chromatid bars you can see. Refractile chromatoid bars you can see. We already saw that they are like chromatin, right? So they are refractile chromatoid bars. Remember this chromatoid bars, what they have, we have seen. They stain like chromatin. That's why they are called as chromatoid bars. Okay. So guys, we have reached here. The cysts we are looking at, they have refractile chromatoid bars, right? So we have represented that here. Then, to demonstrate some dead trophozoites and cysts, they are using some iodine stained preparation, okay? Iodine stained preparation they are using for dead trophozoites and cysts. They are using some CYCTS, right? CYST. For demonstrating these dead trophozoites and cysts, they are using iodine stained preparation and some trichome stain to see the intercellular aspects, okay? In stool examination, they are saying at least three stool samples are good because sometimes these cysts and trophozoites are excreted intermittently, okay? Now moving on to the next topic here, after stool examination, you should have what? Okay, they are explaining mucosal scrapings, okay? Mucosal scrapings, scraping obtained by sigmoidoscopy, okay, into the sigmoid colon, they are going to do something, they take the scraping of the mucus and examination in wet mount or iron hematoxylin or immunofluorescent staining, okay, from sigmoidoscopy, you can take the mucosal scraping, okay, you can do direct wet mount or iron hematoxylin or immunofluorescent staining. Okay, so many things you can do with the mucus scraping. Then coming to stool culture. Now guys, we are moving on to stool culture. Stool culture is a sensitive method in diagnosing chronic and asymptomatic. Okay, so what you will do here, you will use some media like this called as Boeck Derbo Lab NIH polygenic media, Craig's medium, Nelson's medium, Robin's medium, so many are there, okay? Then, serodiagnosis. Now we are moving on to serodiagnosis, guys. Now in serodiagnosis, you can use the same things. Only in invasive amoebiasis, this will help. Then why are you calling it as intestinal amoebiasis? In invasive amoebiasis, it will help because it has to reach the blood, right? So, what and all you can detect here, you can detect what and all methods are there, indirect hemagglutination test, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. See, the thing is, in the exam you will be writing only IHA, RISA for everything, so at least write the full form, okay. Indirect hemagglutination IHA test, then you have enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, okay. So what will you see in indirect hemagglutination test? Serum with antibody titer of 1:256 or more by indirect hemagglutination test is diagnostic of amoebic hepatitis. So it should be titer, antibody titer 1:256, okay. Greater than this, greater than or equal to 1:256 is positive, okay? Positive for what? Amoebic hepatitis. Oh, hepatitis. I thought we were looking at intestinal amoebiasis. Okay. Anyways, then enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay. Commercially available tests are available. These are less expensive, easily performed, okay? And they are being used with great frequency. It is sensitive than microscopy. and they have advantages over microscopy. Coming to latex agglutination test, that's all, just latex agglutination test. This is commonly used, okay. Then coming to molecular diagnosis, guys, molecular diagnosis, you have DNA probe, radioimmunoassay. These are used to detect Entamoeba histolytica in the stool, rapid and specific. This is rapid and specific. Molecular diagnosis is specific. Obviously, you're going to the DNA level. Rapid and specific. This is rapid also, that is nice. So, we are done with intestinal amoebiasis lab diagnosis. In the next video, we will look at the lab diagnosis of extra-intestinal amoebiasis, guys. Extra-intestinal amoebiasis, we'll come back and look at it, okay? Take a break, enjoy, and then come back, okay? Bye.